I'm here to discuss the move to Next Generation 911, or NG911. The nation's 911 system is evolving toward supporting NG911. NG911 will replace the current 911 system while retaining its core features, such as automatically providing call takers with your phone number and location. NG911 will also add new 911 capabilities in multiple formats, such as texting, photos, video, and email, and will support 911 access from all types of originating service providers, application developers, and device manufacturers. NG911 also will more fully integrate the 911 call takers, known as public safety answering points, or PSAPs, and dispatchers with police, fire, and emergency medical responders and hospitals. This will vastly improve the quality and speed of response and give all callers, including people with disabilities, equal service. The possibility of sending video and photographs to the 911 call taker will transcend language barriers and provide eyewitness quality information to give first responders the most relevant information at the scene of an emergency. Now let's talk about how using broadband can bridge the gap to NG911. Many in the public safety community, including PSAPs, lack access to broadband services, yet the transition from the legacy 911 systems to NG911 has begun. Several states and localities have begun deploying NG911, and at least one ongoing live test of texting to 911 is underway. However, financial and regulatory barriers hinder NG911 implementation. Grant programs that support NG911 are uncoordinated and limited in scope. Inconsistent, overlapping, and outdated state and federal regulations also have slowed NG911 development. Accordingly, our NG911 related recommendations focus on fostering a rapid transition from analog, voice-centric 911 and emergency communication systems to a broadband-enabled, IP-based emergency services model. So what are our recommendations? First, the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration should prepare a report to identify the cost of deploying a nationwide NG911 system. The report then should be a resource for Congress as it considers creating a coordinated, long-term funding mechanism for NG911 deployment and operation. Second, Congress should consider enacting a federal legal regulatory framework that would remove jurisdictional and legal barriers and inconsistent legacy regulations. The legislation should also give the FCC the authority to implement an NG911 federal regulatory framework, eliminate outdated 911 regulations at the federal level, and preempt inconsistent state regulations. Third, Congress should consider amending and reauthorizing the Enhanced 911 Act and restoring the E911 Implementation Coordination Office with appropriate funding. The ICO could manage a potential new NG911 grant program and help ensure NG911 is deployed in an interoperable and reliable fashion. Fourth, the FCC should conduct a couple of proceedings that address IP-based communications devices, applications, and services. The first proceeding would expand an existing inquiry into location accuracy and automatic location identification requirements to explore how NG911 may affect these issues. The second proceeding would initiate a broad inquiry to explore how public expectations may evolve as new broadband and IP-based communication services, devices, applications, and technologies develop, and how deployment of NG911 can meet these expectations and accommodate new forms of communication. Thanks for listening.